Ugh, we're back. We took a little bit of a break for the new year, you know, for the holidays, all that shit. Hope y'all guys have had a good new year. We got new goals, we got new places to be in life. I took a little, I think it was like a 10-day break maybe of even recording, but we're back with new beer. New Belgium, we got Juicy Haze IPA, Voodoo Ranger. 7.5% alcohol by volume, not too bad for an IPA, but it's packed with bright tropical aromas and brilliant citrusy flavors. This unfiltered IPA wraps up with pleasantly smooth finish. And let me tell you, it does. Go ahead and pop this. I just mopped. That's fucking stupid of me. We're taking a break on the Eminem train because I'm all Eminem'd out. Talk about YouTube burnout. Tired of listening to just one artist all the time. So while I've been listening to all this Eminem and Linkin Park and all these tracks trying to do old music, we got new music that's been released. I have been keeping up with 21 Savage a little bit. The fact that he's changed his whole style around. He's trying to change who he is, donating to charities, doing the whole works. No more jewelry. It's a good look. It's cool to see somebody go through that transformation like that. But he put out an album while I was on this Eminem train. I'm getting off real quick. We'll hop back on the train in a little bit. But we're gonna jump on the first track on 21 Savage's. It's called A Lot, and it's featuring J. Cole. I haven't even heard it, but I heard great things about it. But we about to find out. Let's just go in and jump right into the damn thing.
I love you. Turn my headphone down a little bit. Mm. Yeah.
I really like that little sample, that soulful sample that they got pitched up a little bit. Reminds me of old school Kanye, the old Kanye. Chop up the soul Kanye.
Yeah.
That beat drop though, I got that same vibe when I heard Rider Music by 50 Cent for the first time when that beat dropped. I was like, oh, okay, I could see myself getting a speeding ticket to this. I wouldn't even be mad about it. Put it on my tab.
This is gonna cost you.
Put it on my tab.
What was that?
Put it on my tab.
How much money you got? A lot. How many problems you got? A lot. Mm. How many people that doubted? A lot. Left you out to rot? A lot. Mm. How many predators you flaunt? A lot. How many lawyers you got? A lot. How many times you got shot? A lot. How many niggas you shot? A lot.
It's already a vibe. The whole a lot thing, it's like, it's on that same repetitive vibe that a lot of hip hop is about these days, but we actually got a little bit of meaningful lyrics behind them. He says, how much money you got and how much problems you got? A lot. More money, more problems. How many people done doubted you? A lot. A lot of people doubted 21 Savage because obviously he don't sound like anybody else in the game, especially his peers that he's coming up with. The cool thing is that when you see the song title, when you see a lot, without even hearing the song, you think he's gonna be bragging about all the shit he has, like got a lot of money, got a lot of diamonds, got a lot of cars, got a lot of chicks. But when you hear the song, it's so chill, the beat. And then it's introspective, like, look at all these problems and all these issues that I got. A lot.
How many times did you ride a lot? How many niggas done die a lot? How many times did you cheat a lot? How many times did you lie a lot? Mm. How many times did she leave a lot? How many times did she cry a lot? How many chances she done gave you? Fuck around, we be dying.
That whole last part where he's talking about chicks and how many times that you done cheated, how many chances she gave you, how many times you've been fucking around with these thoughts. It just reminds me of Song Cry by Jay-Z because the sample is that high-pitched female sample and it's talking about the same kind of topic that Jay-Z did on Song Cry. I can't see him coming down my eyes, but I gotta let this song cry. How many times did you ride? A lot. Down to ride no matter what for all the 21 gang. How many done died? He had his brother got shot and killed, his homie who was like his brother got shot and killed on his 21st birthday. One of those is the reason why he has the dagger right here, he has the knife.
Yeah, you fuck around, we be dying. Every day that I'm alive, I'ma ride with this stick. Mm. I'd rather be broke in jail than be dead and rich. Tell my brothers, take my breath if I turn to a snitch. But I'm 21 for L, ain't no way I'ma switch.
See, that's why people like 21 Savage. His lyrics are not the most in-depth, they're not the most complex of all time, there's no double, triple entendres, anything like that, but his voice, his delivery, and it sounds so clean. Every day that I'm alive, I'ma ride with a stick, some type of firearm, cause I'd rather be broke in jail than be dead and rich. Where it's the opposite for a lot of people. Jay-Z in one of his songs on the Black Album, I think it was Allure, he said, die young, leaving a good looking corpse. Him and even Cole on one of Cole's old songs said that, Which one would you rather be? Because those are really the only two options in this rap game. Broken in jail, dead and rich. That's a dope line. Told my brothers take my breath before I turn to a snitch. Because I'm 21 for L, like for life. Ain't no way I'ma switch. I'll die before I snitch on anybody in my group, in my crew, in my family.
Penitential chances just to make a couple bucks. My heart's so cold, I could put it in my cup. Gang versus the world, me and my dog, it was us. Then you went and wrote a statement, and that really fucked me up.
Like a lot of rap nowadays, especially in his class of rappers, they're not really writing shit like this. This is more along the lines of Cole, along the lines of Kendrick. Maybe not the same complexity in rhyme scheme and pattern and topics, but just to be able to look back at his life and all the shit that he's gone through. A lot of rappers don't do that anymore. Penitentiary chances just to make a couple bucks. That's cold because you're taking a high risk doing shit that's highly illegal just to make a couple bucks. Like, what do these bucks really matter in the long run if you're gonna lose your freedom? My heart is so cold I could put it in my cup. Like, literally talking probably about purple syrup, talking about lean. His heart is cold as ice. The gang versus the world, and then somebody snitched on him or made a statement. I'm not too sure on who it was that made a statement, but he's basically implying somebody went and snitched or somebody went and said something that they should have. And that fucked him up because he thought that everybody was ride or die. Take my breath before I turn to a snitch. He thought everybody else was like that, and obviously it wasn't the case.
My brother lost his life and it turned me to a beast. My brother got life and it turned me to the streets. I've been through the storm and it turned me to a G. But the other side was sunny. I get paid to rap on beats. How much money you got? A lot. How many problems you got?
The beat is so fire, like I can't even explain to you how much I like this instrumental. My brother lost his life and that turned me to a beast. Literally, his brother was shot and killed, and so was his friend, like I said earlier, that was his other brother on his 21st birthday. I think he was shot and killed, and 21 Savage was also shot like 5 or 6 times in that same incident. As he's talking about all this bad shit that's happened, he sees the silver lining because he says, I've been through the storm and it turned me to a G. Which he obviously literally a gangster, which he was, by like losing family, losing friends to death by murder for drug deals and things like that. But the other side was sunny because I get paid to rap on these beats. Like, he already sees that upswing, that silver lining. Like, that's a dope line to be able to say, I've been through all this shit. Because someone's going to hear this song that's going through the same shit and realize that there's an upside. It might not be rap. It might not be whatever. It might be school. It might be work. But there's an upside to every downside.
Home, 6 hour drive, 6 and a half. Before I left, I stopped by and see my nigga 21 in the studio. Yeah, 12 of his kids with him right in the studio. That's what I knew. Stand up, nigga. I love seeing shit like that.
This is something that we love about J. Cole, is that he's a storyteller. Even when he's not rapping yet, he's telling a story about how he left the A, Atlanta, was driving back to North Carolina. The fact that this dude is driving from Atlanta to North Carolina, 6.5 hour drive. He could fly, he could take a private jet, but he's so not about those possessions like everybody else is. And I think that might be why 21 got him on this song. But yeah, he's telling us the story that he met 21 Savage in studio. He didn't have no bitches there. It was just him and two of his kids. And that's dope because old 21 Savage, that might not have been the case.
Yeah, that's what I know. Stand up, nigga. I love seeing shit like that. Question. How many faking they streams? Getting they plays from machines. I can see behind the smoke and mirrors, niggas ain't really big as they seem.
He's already calling out people for faking their streams. Just like YouTubers and Instagrammers, they fake their views. Anything that's digital, anything that has an algorithm to it to determine success, there's a way to hack that. They pay money to this company. This company hires people that all they do is just click on links all day long just to get activity up. Even if that activity isn't really anything. It's like ghost activity, just like ghost followers that you can pay for. It's just the fact that there's activity that's getting you into the algorithm's notice, and then you're more searched, you're found easier, you're in the notification pages, the explore page of Instagram, the trending page of YouTube, the first page of Google. So this is what he's saying. He's saying a lot of people have been faking their streams, getting their plays from machines. No one's actually really listening, but your streams make it look like they are because you paid to have somebody fake those stream counts.
They plays from machines. I can see behind the smoke and mirrors, niggas ain't really big as they seem. I never say anything. Everybody got their thing. Some niggas make millions. Other niggas make memes.
That's where that line is from. I remember seeing the meme. You know, like DJ Khaled, he's a successful, but he's just a meme on the internet, basically. Tekashi is just a meme on the internet as well. These are the reasons why a lot of people have their fame, and then people find their music because of it. J. Cole is saying that some people make millions, other people make memes. Like, he's not in it for that type of false recognition. He wants the recognition to be on his artwork. That's a dope line.
Other niggas make memes. I'm on a money routine. I don't
won't smoke, I won't crane. I don't want no more comparisons. This is a marathon, and I'm aware I've been playing a bet from a lack of promotions. I never was one for the bragging and boasting. I guess I was hoping the music would speak for itself, but the people want everything else. Okay, no.
This is why this song is dope already. 21 was looking back at his life, where J. Cole hops on. He's looking back an introspective lens at his career. So the whole song is both of these successful artists looking back at different times and what they were before. He says, I don't want smoke, I want cream. I'm not here to diss anybody. I'm not here to, like that shit that he had where the little pump. He's not here for that shit. He's just here for the money. Cream, cash rules, everything around me. Wu-Tang Clan, if you don't know, best learn. It's a marathon. I'm aware that I've been playing a bet with from my lack of promotions. I was never one for bragging and boasting. Anyone that knows anything about J. Cole and his last three albums, KOD, For Your Eyes Only, 2014 Forest Hills Drive, all of these albums have no features. There wasn't a single radio single that was made specifically to promote the album. He didn't promote the actual albums themselves. He just dropped them and the fans took him platinum. He's been betting on himself with the lack of promotions that he's been having because he's not really all about that bragging and boasting. I was hoping that the music would speak for itself, but these people want everything else. He wanted to be able to go platinum, which he has twice already, with no features, no hit singles. Even though he's having the success, everybody still wants everything else. They don't want that. They want the bragging and boasting and gloating and the money and the bitches, all that. So he's saying, if that's what you want.
Okay, no problem, I show up on everyone now, when you know what the outcome will be. I'm back at 1,000, it's got to the point that these rappers don't even like rapping with me. Fuckin' come on, nigga, 21 Savage just hit me and told me.
You hear that line? He says, y'all want that gloating and boasting, I'll just show up on everyone's album, out rap them to the point where these artists don't want to be rapping with me even on their own album, because I'm batting 1,000. He showed up on like 10 or 12 different tracks in 2018, and they were all bangers because he was on them. It's to the point these other rappers don't want to be rapping with me. That's a dope line.
Rappers don't even like rapping with me. Fuck it, come on, nigga. 21 Savage just hit me and told me he sent me a spot on a new record he got. He called it a lie. I open my book and I jot. Akashi, they wanted a rap. I picture him inside a cell on a cot, reflecting on how he made it to the top, wondering if it was worth it or not. I pray for my kill because they fucked up a shot. Just want you to know that you got it, my nigga. Though I never met you, I know that you special. When that the Lord bless you, don't doubt it, my nigga.
That Takashi line. Now we're talking about Takashi being locked up. What is it for? For racketeering charges and this gang that he's supposedly affiliated with. We're talking introspectively on this song, and then we bring up another rapper and we're wondering if he's being introspective while he's in prison about the decisions that he's made to get him to this point. Like, were the decisions that he made worth it? Is he wondering that while he's in prison? Like, he's got the money, he's got the fame. What can he do with it while he's locked up in the clink? As Michael Scott would say.
Oh, wow. Yes. All right, hey, that's just the way we talk in the clink. Been a lot of fun talk about prison today.
Then back to the brotherhood and the camaraderie between him and 21. He's saying nobody else is calling him for features because they're too scared to rap on the track with him. But that's cool because 21's got my back on this new album that he's got and this song called A Lot. And it's dope because he's like, this isn't about competition. This is just about both of us going in. That's all either one of us are concerned about. That's our job as artists, is to bring out these bangers for y'all and make y'all think with these in-depth introspective lyrics. This is a dope song. This is a dope way to open this album.
And it's my dream, stay solid, my nigga. I'm on a tangent, not how I planned it. I had some fans that hopped in a band and shit when they thought that I wasn't gonna pan. Now I got a plan. They say the success is the greater revenge. Tell all your friends, call on a mission, submit in the spot is the greatest that did it before it all ends, nigga. How much money you got? A lot. How many problems?
I had some friends that hopped on an abandoned ship when they thought that I wasn't gonna pan out. I got a plan. Like, that could be talking about two moments in his career. The moment that he was already seen as the chosen one, but they were holding back on his release date for months and months because he didn't have a radio single. People had hopped off an abandoned ship at that point because he kept on getting pushed back and delayed. So they were like, ah, nah, fuck this dude. But then he got the hits. Then he put out albums. But then he put out 2014 Forest Hills Drive, automatic classic, automatic banger. That's the first one that he had, triple platinum, no features. And then he put out For Your Eyes Only, and people couldn't see the vision of that album. It was a concept album. They wanted bangers. They wanted hits like they had on 2014 Forest Hills Drive. but that album is supposed to be listened to front to back. He's not even writing it in his own perspective. Fairweather fans can see that they abandoned ship, and then they were talking shit on KOD as well, but that's also a concept album, talking about drugs and their paraphernalia and things that are glamorized and glorified in rap and how it shouldn't be. And then he says, they say that success is the greatest revenge, tell all your friends. That I'm on a mission, submitting my spot as the greatest that ever did it before it all ends. The moment he stops rapping, he's gonna be up there. The list is gonna be fluctuating to make sure that he's up there. He's top 15 maybe right now in my eyes. But he'll be top 10, no doubt about it, when it's all said and done. Yo, that is a strong way to open up an album. Especially for 21 Savage, who normally doesn't have these type of songs. I'm glad that this is the song that we chose during our little break from Eminem, because this is a whole different side of 21 that people need to see. It's cool to see somebody go from typical rap, switching his whole demeanor and his whole image around, to being the person that he's trying to be now. Thank y'all guys for being here. As I always say, like the video if you like it. Comment if you wish to comment. We're still wondering where all my followers and fans and whatever you want to call yourselves from. Family, more like it. Subscribe if you're not subscribed yet, especially if this is not your first video. And hit the notification bell. That's probably most important to make sure that you are made aware when I post new videos. Love y'all guys. Appreciate y'all watching. And as always, peace.